The Saudi king is not the only autocrat getting the soft treatment by this president. I want to play for you Trump's responses when asked about North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un and Russian President Vladimir Putin.
This is a guy you love.
I know all these things. I mean, I'm not a baby. I know all these things.
Why do you love that guy?
Look. I get along with him, okay?
But you said you love him.
Okay, that's just like a figure of speech.
No, it's like an embrace.
Let it be an embrace. Let it be whatever it is to get the job done.
He's a bad guy.
Look, let it be whatever it is. I get along with him really well. I have a good energy with him. I have a good chemistry with him. Look at the horrible threats that were made. No more threats.
Do you agree that Vladimir Putin is involved in assassinations? In poisonings?
Probably he is, yeah. Probably. I mean, I don't...
Probably?
Probably, but I rely on them. It's not in our country.
Okay, why not? They shouldn't do it. This is a terrible thing.
Of course they shouldn't do it.
Let's go to CNN politics reporter and editor-at-large Chris Cillizza. And Chris, I mean, that was Putin and Kim, right? And now we're talking about the Saudi king. Is there a trend you are noticing?
Yeah, so there's a blueprint here a little bit, Brooke, which is, you know, you played earlier Donald Trump talking about his conversation with King Salman, in which he says he denies it. He denies it very strongly, and then suggesting it could have been some rogue killers. Okay, you'll remember back Donald Trump talking about Vladimir Putin and the conversation they had about, here he is, talking about Russian meddling in the election, Russian interference in the election. He denies it. He denies it very strongly. And remember, in October 2016, Donald Trump talking in a debate with Hillary Clinton, he said it could have been, wait for it, Russia, China, or a 400-pound guy sitting on his couch in New Jersey. So this is not new. And then I want to just expand it outward just a little bit more, because I think these matter the most and are very, very similar. But you'll remember Brett Kavanaugh, right? Supreme Court Justice. Now, about the sexual assault allegations against Kavanaugh, Trump was very quick to say he denies it. He denies it strongly. Roy Moore, running for the Senate in Alabama, a number of women saying he pursued relationships with them when they were teenagers. He denies it. He denies it very strongly. And then Rob Porter, the former White House staff secretary, accused of domestic abuse by both of his ex-wives. He denies it. He says he's innocent. He does it very strongly. All of these are people that Donald Trump likes in one way, shape, or form. He talked in that clip you played about Putin. Well, you could put Kim Jong-un on here, King Salman, and then these three obviously are people he either endorsed or worked for him or he supported. The problem for Donald Trump is he doesn't bring that same standard about believing people who deny things. Remember, this is a guy who has said Ted Cruz's father might have been involved in the JFK assassination, a guy who said Barack Obama wiretapped him in Trump Tower, despite all U.S. intelligence saying that's not true. So he believes deniers when they support him or things he previously believes. He's unwilling to do so when it relates to the opposite. It's a double standard. He has a double standard on lots of things. I think this is a big one and was highlighted today. Brooke.
So as you highlighted, and as we all watched the 60 interview with Leslie mm-hmm. Stahl, there, let's talk about the painting. The painting in the president's private residence, right? We've spot shadowed it, and we're actually going to talk to the painter next hour. But we're within the painting, mm-hmm. there are starbursts
yep.
and a direct TV remote.
This is like my dream setup, by the way. This number of starbursts, I would eat a lot of those.
Yeah. Are you a cherry or are you a orange?
I like pink lemonade. Okay, so here's what I think is important. Number one, look, let's not overlook the fact that it's kind of weird to have a picture of yourself in around with all the other presidents. Like, I don't have a picture of myself in my office, particularly not a painting. But yes, look, we know this is a fact. This is the most important thing in the room. I have it, he has it, a DirecTV clicker, because he watches a ton of television. It is the lens by which he sees the world. There are any number of examples of that, whether it's his Twitter feed, whether it's things he has said where he learns about military strategy when he's a candidate from watching the shows. He is the biggest consumer of cable news we have ever had in the White House. He is someone who cares deeply about what Chiron's, the lower third there below me, says. He cares more than any past president about all these things. And I think this is illustrative. He cares about where he fits in the broader sort of sphere of presidents. He talks about how he's gotten more done than anyone. He talks about how he might be even more popular than Honest Abe, talking about Abe Lincoln. He's very aware of his surroundings in a way that he tries to play off and says he is not, but we know he is. Honestly, you should just spot shadow this. I know this gets a lot of attention.
Yeah.
This is the key.
TV
this
remote.
Is the key to Donald Trump.